Hey, this is Paul from Wondershare MobileTrans, and welcome to another video. And you might have seen in the past couple of weeks, Apple has released the iOS 16 beta, and at WWDC, it was one of the first things that Apple have showed off. And of course, when a new iOS comes about, there's always new features, new upgrades, and things that people want to get their hands on straight away. But the official release of iOS 16 is not coming out until fall 2022. However, if you want, you can actually download that developer beta right now. And that's exactly what we're going to show you in today's video. We're going to show you exactly how you can download the iOS 16 beta for your phone right now. But before we get into that and show you how to do it, why not subscribe to the MobileTrans channel so you don't miss a single video that we upload here to YouTube. And if you've done that, let's get into today's video. Now that we have the iOS 16 developer beta out, it's now really exciting that we can go and download this and try it out for ourselves and our devices. And if you're one of those people, you might be wondering, well, how do I download it? And of course, we'll show you how to do that in today's video. But there are a few things you need to be careful of before you go ahead and download the iOS 16 beta. Remember, if you're going to download iOS 16, then it is still in developer mode. So all these iOS 16 final features might not work as well as you want. There might be connectivity issues, apps might not work, and then there could be some issues with your battery life as well because they are just finalizing what iOS 16 is. So this is not exactly how that final version will go. So you need to be just a little bit careful if this is something that you want to do. iOS 16 Developer Beta 2 has just been released this week, and so far from testing, the first developer beta actually seemed to hold up pretty well. But like I mentioned, you need to make sure you take the precautions before downloading the developer beta. And sometimes the best thing to do is not install this on your main device. So if you have a secondary device and you're lucky enough to do so, I would suggest downloading the developer beta on that. And if you're going to use a secondary device or maybe even your primary device, remember, just back it up first. You need to make sure you back up everything because as it's a developer beta, this could go wrong and you could lose everything. And if you want to use an iPhone to get this new iOS 16 developer beta, it has to be an iPhone 8 or newer. So any iPhones below that, iPhone 7, iPhone 6S, they will not work and they will not take iOS 16. The best way to get this iOS 16 beta is directly through Apple. And by doing that, you would become a developer, but you have to pay $99 to become that developer. But you can do it. All you need to do is go over to their website and sign up, register, and then you can download the iOS 16 beta profile. But what if you want to try the iOS 16 beta for free? Well, you can. You can wait until around about July for the public beta to come out, which means anyone can test it. But if you don't want to wait until July and you still want to download this iOS 16 beta, then let me show you exactly what you would need to do to do it. And if you want to do this on iPhone or iPad, you can follow the same steps because they are essentially exactly the same. First of all, on your iPhone, you need to download the iOS 16 or iPadOS 16 beta configured profile. Then you need to download and install that iOS 16 or iPadOS 16 beta profile to your phone. For the next pop-up window on the phone screen, click the close button and then navigate to settings. And then go to the profile downloaded option. And if this option isn't available for yourself, you can go into the settings tab and then you can find and select the profile downloaded option that appears in the menu. You just need to make sure you find the required one and then you'll need to enter your passcode. And then what you'll have to do is accept this and agree to the terms page and click install. After that, reboot your iOS device and enable iOS 16. And after you've finished all of these steps, you need to restart your iPhone. Go to settings after restarting the iPhone and click the iOS 16 developer beta now. The upgrade process will take a bit of time depending on the network type and of course your download speeds. You can though keep it running in the background while performing other tasks. Once that is all downloaded, it will just reboot your iPhone and then iOS 16 developer beta will be on your phone and you can explore all those new features that iOS 16 or iPadOS 16 has to offer. And we'll say it again, remember, this is a developer beta, so that means there are going to be problems along the way. And still, it's relatively new in its developer beta early phases, so we're not exactly sure how they are all going to appear, those issues and problems. But there are some that we are aware of already. There is some misconfiguration of settings and other functions not working. So for example, Wi-Fi sometimes will not work, and then certain aspects of the phone, like AirDrop, will not work as well. And trying to save photos and documents online would mean that that doesn't work as well. So you need to be a little bit careful, because that is one of the problems. But of course, as it's developer beta, it's not over there. There are other problems as well. You also get slow performance on some devices running iOS 16 developer beta. And of course, some devices will run absolutely fine, but others are a little bit slow. Opening and closing apps is slow. Sometimes the lock screen, that won't unlock. You then have to do a soft reset, or just trying to make phone calls will not work. Some users have also said that they have got data loss as well on their phone, where the developer beta hasn't quite worked. They've had to reset their phone and they have lost everything once they've resetted it to that factory setting. So of course, you need to make sure that your data is backed up and safe before getting this iOS 16 developer beta. And we know the program exactly for you to use, and it is called MobileTrans. As we mentioned, people going to iOS 16 developer beta have lost their data, and that is a nightmare if you lose all your photos, contacts, documents, images, everything. You can lose it by doing this. So the best thing to do is back up here to MobileTrans, and I will show you exactly what you need to do, because it is nice, quick, and easy. So just follow these steps. First of all, you need to connect your phone to the computer and launch MobileTrans. In the menu, you then need to click Backup and Restore, and this will launch the Backup and Restore interface of the MobileTrans toolkit. Then, choose file types and begin that backup. Following that, MobileTrans will load all supported file types, and it supports a variety of file formats for iPhone and Android devices. Then, choose the file types to backup and click the Start button. Within a few minutes, that backup will be completed, but just make sure your phone is connected for the entire process. By selecting the MobileTrans backup file from the Restore module, you can see what has been backed up using the Restore. And if the worst thing happens and you need to restore your data from that backup that you just made, then let me show you how you would do that by using your computer. Again, doesn't take long, it's nice and simple, so just follow the steps. First of all, download and install MobileTrans on your computer, and then when the installation is complete, you need to launch the app, and you will see several options available on that home screen. You need to navigate to Backup and Restore, and then launch the Backup and Restore module on your computer. From the list of backup records, select the backup file you want to restore. Then, navigate to the MobileTrans backup file. If you made multiple backups, you need to select the MobileTrans backup file from what you want to extract. Then, choose file types and start the data restoration. Remember, just choose those file types that you want to restore and select Start. This can take some time to complete. Just make sure you're nice and patient, and you can select the clear data before copy to clear the iPhone's current data. And remember, this is not turned on by default. There we go. That is how you would backup and restore your data using MobileTrans. And you will need to do that if you want to download the iOS 16 developer beta, because of course, there are still problems with it being in such an early stage of its development. Anything can happen to your data, so it is best to make sure you back it up using a trusted source, and that is MobileTrans. If you enjoyed today's video, then of course, give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and turn on that notification bell as well, so you don't miss any of the videos that we upload here to the channel. And if you've done all of that, then we will see you in the next video.